Hi there. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how to create a simple water surface. I'm going to show a couple of techniques to add ripples to the surface, and then finally how you can have an object that's sitting in the water cause circular ripples all around it. I've already got a basic scene here where I've got a surface here that represents a riverbank. I've got a plane here, and I've just added a simple cube under here to help us see when we are looking through the water. This plane here is obviously going to be our water plane. I've also got a representation of a sun up here, which is set to an emission strength of 4 and a size of 0.025. The ground is currently just a simple mid-brown diffuse color, and I've got a sky texture set up. So if we look at this in rendered view, we can see it's very simple. So I'm going to pull down a new window, go to the node editor, and select my water. We're going to say new to create a new material, and we'll call this water. And I'm going to remove the default diffuse. I'm going to add a shader, which is the principal shader, and just connect that into the surface. I'm going to give it a base color for the moment that's slightly dark green color. And the only parts of this shader that we need to worry too much about, you need to make sure metallic is at 0, which by default it will be. Specular can stay at 0.5. Roughness we can play around with. And let's set that to 0 at the moment. And you can see we've now got a very reflective surface. There's our sun reflecting, and that's essentially a complete reflection of what it's currently seeing. If I turn transmission up to maximum, we still got the reflection, but we're also showing what's underneath the water, coloured by this colour. So the first method for adding ripples to the surface, I'm going to add a subdivision surface first, just to add still more geometry. I did a subdivision of 100 by 100, so it's got a fair bit of geometry, but by adding this subdivision surface, I'm adding even more. And now I'm going to add the displace modifier. And you can see the whole surface just goes off up here somewhere initially. I'm going to click New. I'm going to call the texture Large Ripples. And then I'm going to click this button to go to textures and change this to clouds. So you can see we've got very big noise at the moment. I'm going to change the size to 0.05 for the moment. See what that looks like. Maybe that's a bit too small. We'll go for 0.1. Then we'll come back to the modifiers. We'll put the strength, we'll try 0.1 to start with. It's still much too big, so we'll go for 0.01. So now you can see we've got a very simple ripple on the surface. Now we could continue and add another displace modifier with a higher noise frequency and so on in order to build up layers of noise in the surface of the water. There's some downsides to doing it with the displace modifier. It's heavier in terms of needing geometry, for example. You need the geometry for these ripples to be visible. But even aside from that, this water doesn't look quite right yet because we need to do a little bit more with the reflections. They're not quite working as real reflections work yet. So I'm going to add an input, which is a layer weight input, and I'm going to take the facing output to transmission. And you can see it all got a bit darker there. If I take this all the way up to 1, essentially, unless it's reflecting light, it's completely transparent. If I take this down to 0, it's either reflecting light or it's reflecting diffuse light, hence we're getting this green colour. So we could have it something like 0.5, so we've got a little bit of colour there, because I'm assuming this is water with perhaps algae in it or something like that. The other side of it is the roughness. So up at maximum, we get full reflection, but of course it looks weird, it looks like milk or something. So what we need to do is adjust that, and if we put the Fresnel output into there, we can start to do that. So you now see we're getting basically a specular reflection, but that's obviously much too much. So I'm going to add a color ramp, and we just drop that in there, and then we can adjust that specular reflection. And essentially all we're doing is adding a slight roughness to the surface, almost like very, very small ripples, to give us a better effect. I'm also going to add a second color ramp, and I'm going to drag that green color to the color ramp. I'm going to take the facing output and put that into the input of the color ramp, and the color output into here. And I'm going to swap those two over. So now what we've got, if I look from above, is the opportunity to adjust how transparent our object is, but also how much greenish light is reflected as well. I'm going to go to 0.95 now, and again, when you adjust that, because of the way that it's set up, we'll need to adjust this color ramp here, because this is, as I say, adjusting the size of this reflection here, and perhaps set this one to B spline just to give it a softer fall off. So you just need to play around with these to get the look that you're trying to achieve and the amount of translucence that you want. So this is really just determining, based on the angle of the light bouncing off the water, exactly how much goes a little bit into the water and comes out coloured, or in other words is diffuse, and how much of it is just reflected off the surface or just goes straight down through it. You don't necessarily need to use this option. This just adds a little bit of complication, but it gives you a little bit more control as well. The next thing we want to do is to look at a different way of adding ripples. So if I turn off the displace modifier, I can add a texture which is a noise texture. Now this is already UV unwrapped, and therefore Blender will assume that the whole thing is UV unwrapped. I now need to add a new node, which is a vector node called bump. Take the color or factor output into the height of the bump node, then take the purple output of the bump node into the purple input on layer weight, and the purple input into the normal purple input on the principal shader. You can see we've sort of got our low frequency noise back again. If I now turn the scale of the noise up quite a bit, you can see we're getting ripples again, and perhaps turn the strength down slightly. And for this, I'm going to add the detail as well, because the good thing about this is if we increase the detail, we'll get tiny ripples as well, much more like real water. And although it will stop at 16 when you just slide it that way, you can actually click it and type in an even higher number. And this is one of the occasions when adding a little bit of distortion actually works quite well, because it sort of simulates little swirls in the water. So you don't need too much, but just add a little bit of that. And it just gives you, you see, I put it too much there, but you can see the sort of swirls. If that's the sort of stylized effect you want, then go for it. But perhaps 0.25, something like that. And you just get a little bit of that in the surface. And that's very quickly added some ripples to the surface. Perhaps we come back a little bit on the strength. And if we want to, we can have the displace modifier as well. I'll just put that back on. Perhaps make it even smaller than that, 0.007. And that's the basic ripples. All of these are animatable. If you wanted to animate it, what you would need to do is an input node, which is texture coordinate. By default, of course, we've unwrapped it, so we would just take the UV output from there and plug it into the vector input on the noise texture. That shouldn't make any difference whatsoever, because we were already working to UV coordinates. And then you would add a vector mapping node and just drop that there. And then all you need to do is animate, for example, the X coordinates, and that will just move through the noise. That will animate this. So let's turn our noise off for a moment. We can just turn the strength down to zero. Let's set our X location there, and then go to the end of the animation, and let's set it to 1 and record that. I'm just going to quickly go to the graph editor, go to the key and set interpolation mode to linear, so that it's not very, very slow changing to begin with, speeds up and then slows down again. It'll just be a constant speed. Back to our node editor, don't worry too much about that. So let's see if that makes any difference to the displace modifier. So if we note that pattern just there, we can see it's not doing anything. If we go back to the beginning, we turn the displace modifier off, but put our bump strength back up to 0.45. If we notate patterns, say around here, next to that bright spot, there's a dark spot in the middle of it, you can see that it's moving. So there's an actual drift in the pattern that we're seeing on there. Maybe able to show it a little bit if I set the start resolution up a little bit higher here. Yes, you can just about see that there's a flow going on here now. It's probably too fast. If I go to the top there and I set that to 0.5, press I again just to record that, and now press it. And you can just about see, it's not fully rendering obviously, unless I stop it, but you can just about see there is a flow to that. And obviously you can have it go in more than one direction if you need to. But as I've already demonstrated, I'm just going to remove that noise. I just muted the noise by pressing M with that noise texture selected. If I bring my displace modifier back online, again, you can see there's nothing happening there. Really, you'd need to put in an animated noise texture or something like that. So if it is an animation, you may not want to use the displace modifier. But as I showed you, the noise texture is more than capable of giving you some pretty good results. It just depends on what you're trying to do. So finally, what if you wanted to have something in the water that's giving off ripples? And this goes for animated ripples as well, by the way. So let's come out of here and let's add a simple ball, if you like. So we'll add a UV sphere in. We'll just add a subdivision surface on there, and we'll give it a simple material. We'll make it a bright yellow ball. And why not use the principal shader again? So there's our ball. I've made it a reflective ball. So obviously, if you want to, you can put the layer weight node in again. And if we use the Fresnel output, and just come back from 1 slightly, there, so you can see we've got a little bit of reflection here, but what's facing us isn't terribly reflective, it's more diffuse. So there's our ball floating in the water, but there's no ripples or anything coming from it at the moment. We've already got a reasonable amount of geometry, so if we select our water plane again, come over to here, we'll add a modifier, and we'll add the wave modifier this time. I actually demonstrated this a long time ago, but it's time to do it again. If you note here, there's a little object symbol, and we can click this little dropper and select our ball. And you can see our water plane is all the way up there. Let's set the height to 0.1, maybe even smaller than that, 0.05. We can at least start to see our ball again. If I press play, you can see what's actually happening is that the whole plane is currently moving up and down, but you can see there's a slight wave to it. I'm also going to temporarily disable the displacement modifier just to make things a little easier, and the subsurface modifier. Now we can see things a little better. So we can play around with things like the width of the ripples, which is essentially what we've got here. So the space between the ripples, if you like, how tight the individual ripples are, and the speed of them. So you can see they're much slower ones there. We can add some fall off, so they get smaller as they go out. And we can change the life of them. So this basically means it will ripple for a period of time, but then stop unless we set it to zero. Normals would change the way that the ripples work if this is a three-dimensional object, but because we've got a flat plane here, it's not going to make too much difference. So let's have a look through the camera. We can see we've got ripples going on. We can use the UV coordinates. It doesn't matter too much again with the plane. Perhaps we want to go a little bit quicker than that. And then if we want to turn on the subsurface, we'll get a little bit finer geometry. And perhaps set the height even lower, 0.03. 0.01 even. So let's put the displace modifier back in. Need to go a bit stronger with the height now, maybe reduce the strength of the displace modifier even further. So let's have a look at that. So now you can see we've just got some very subtle ripples emanating from the ball, and we can play around with the strength of each of them. So if we come up to the wave modifier, we can adjust the height. Perhaps we go to 0.03 now. And there you can see our ripples are quite a bit stronger now. This could be a boat or someone stepping in the water. And the wave modifier is animated, as you saw. So if I just do a slightly better render for that, and we'll see what that's like. So that's not looking too bad. And that looks pretty fair. And that was without any denoising or anything like that. So I hope you liked that tutorial. If you did, let me know. And I'll see you in the next one. Thanks a lot. So I hope you found that interesting. If you did, let me know. If you enjoy these tutorials, don't forget to click like and subscribe. I also have a Facebook page and a Twitter account, and I now have a Patreon page as well. And I'll provide links to all of those in the description below. So I'll see you in the next tutorial. Thanks a lot.